This guy not only wore the Green Bay tie, I think he brought the Green Bay weather with him to the evenings.
Pretty much.
It's great to have you here.
And it's a winning forecast.
Ooh, I like that.
There we go.
I like to hear that.
It was an incredibly cold day, a big difference from what we saw the last couple of days with record warmth and even 60-degree readings. You know, today our high was at midnight, just a little after midnight. And it was 16 degrees, Brandy. It felt great. There's your official almanac today. High of 16, a low of 4. That was later this morning. Again, an average, well below average for our high today. And you can see outside right now, 10 degrees at Epley, mainly clear conditions at dew point. That is very, very dry air. Winds still out of the north at about 12 miles an hour. So, again, I've been waiting to show this. Look at the temperature change in 24 hours. These aren't wind chills. These aren't the actual temperatures. It's just showing a 20 to, in some cases, 40 and 45 degree temperature drop in the last 24 hours, making it incredibly cold outside, but at least it looks pretty nice out there. Let's take a live look outside from the Lewis and Clark Landing, looking back across downtown Omaha. That is a beautiful, cold sunset out there, and it won't be a bad evening. Well, unless you're going outside, temperatures are going to be rather cold, staying in the single digits. Clouds start to increase overnight, and winds will pick up by tomorrow morning as well. That means our temperatures won't drop, but at 7 o'clock with an 8-degree temperature and winds at about 15 miles an hour, that means wind chills are going to be below zero yet again tomorrow morning. So you're going to need the warm weather gear as you are heading out to work. Clear skies this evening. That's going to allow the temperatures to drop pretty quickly into the single digits. And then off to our northwest, we're going to keep northwest flow coming over the next couple of days, and that's just going to shoot these little disturbances out of the northern Rockies. You can see one coming across far southern Canada into Big Sky Country, a few snow showers toward Billings and Helena, Montana. That energy is going to be coming in here by tomorrow afternoon. Now remember, that dew point, 14 below zero, that's incredibly dry air. We're not worried about any precipitation tomorrow, but another one of these quick-moving clipper systems coming in here on Wednesday could bring a little bit of accumulating snow, something we really haven't seen all that much of this season in the metro. Storm predictor this evening, clear skies all the way through midnight. Then the clouds are going to start to increase from west to east, and winds are going to pick up out of the south and southeast as well. So pretty breezy and rather cloudy tomorrow morning. Storm predictor tries to bring in some snowflakes, but again, too dry for any precipitation tomorrow. There are your 7 o'clock temperatures. Single digits in western Iowa, starting to get into the double digits across eastern Nebraska. Still very chilly. Southeast winds turning around to the southwest tomorrow. I still think we'll keep mostly cloudy skies, but look what it does for the temperatures. Tomorrow, we're going to be in the low to mid-20s in Omaha by noon, low 30s off to the west. We'll see temperatures in the low to mid-30s tomorrow before we start seeing northwest winds in the afternoon. And again, no precipitation tomorrow, just a few more clouds in the evening, and you can start to see those cooler temperatures coming in, dropping back into the upper 20s to the north by 5 o'clock. We still might be around 30 degrees in the metro. But then again, Wednesday, I mentioned the chance for a better chance for accumulating snow. Here's the GFS. Again, this is Wednesday. Just a light snow throughout much of the day, maybe 1 to 2 inches across a good part of the viewing area. It's going to be a rather fluffy snow because we're going to see some cooler temperatures coming in by then as well. 34 for a high tomorrow, still near 31 degrees on Tuesday, but then some pretty gusty north winds send us down to 19 for a high on Wednesday with that light snow coming in. Again, I'm only thinking maybe an inch or two across the viewing area. A very cold day, but sunny on Thursday, and then by the end of the week, we're right back riding the roller coaster up into the low and mid 30s. Brandy, this whole month has just been up and down. It looks like we'll keep it going into early 2014.
It makes Nebraska weather very exciting, right?
Especially from my perspective.
I know, exactly. All right, thanks.